Hello class 12. We will do the chapter Organs of the Government, and today we will learn about the unicameral legislature. That is the arguments given for or against the concept or against the unicameral legislature. Now, what is an unicameral legislature? A legislature can consist of two houses, or it can consist of one single house. If the legislature consists of two houses, the upper house and the lower house, then it is known as a bicameral legislature. Whereas when we get only the lower chamber is present, the upper chamber is not present in the legislature, that kind of a legislature is called a unicameral legislature. There are some scholars are there who prefer unicameral legislatures, and there are some scholars who prefer bicameral legislatures. But in the world, in the states, we find both the types of the legislatures. First, we will learn about the arguments, or about those advocates who have given their arguments for the unicameral legislature, and then we will learn about those who have given their arguments against the unicameral legislature. Now, the arguments that are put forward in the case of unicameral legislature is, first of all, that in a unicameral legislature, the determination of responsibility is easy. That is, if there are two houses, then not a single house cannot be held responsible for any of the function that has been performed by the legislature. Whereas, if the house consists of a single chamber, then it is easier to fix the responsibility and the representatives of the people who are there in the legislature. They are also sincere to their work, because they are answerable to the people, so they remain sincere to the functions, to their functions, and as a result, it is easier for the representatives, and also to find out the responsibility, means who is responsible of a particular function. Now, if there are two houses, then one will say that it is not responsible, the other will put it on the other house will put it on the another house. So this kind of a problem doesn't exist in a unicameral legislature. Moreover, there is only one house, the representatives of the people are there, they are answerable to the people, and they make sincere efforts to discharge their responsibilities. This is the first argument that has been given for a unicameral legislature. The second argument that is given is that if the legislature consists of a single house, then it is easier to take quick decisions. If there is an emergency situation, if there is any kind of a problem in the state, then a unicameral legislature, as it consists of a single house, can quickly take a decision. Whereas, if a bicameral legislature is present, then the approval of both the houses are required. In that case, it is a time-taking procedure. So, it is believed that unicameral legislature can take quick decisions, can act much more faster than that of a bicameral legislature. The third argument given for the theory for unicameral legislature is that it is more economical. What do we mean by more economical? If a legislature consists of two houses, then the two houses will have members, there will be representatives, there will be members in both the houses. The state has to bear the expenses of the members, that is, give them the alliances, the facilities and everything. For that, the state, if there is another house, then the expenses of the government is double. The expenses of the state is double, because there is another house, there are members in that house. The state needs to give them the alliances, the capacities that are given to the other house. So in that case, it is only adding to the expenses of the government. And so it is believed that it is better to have one house, because there are various other arguments given that an other house, the second chamber, is only doing a repetition of what is being done in the first house, that is in the lower house. So what is the use of it? Also, it is more economical for the state to have a single legislature where the government does not need to spend an extra amount of money for the alliances or the facilities of the members of the second chamber. The next argument given is that of it is suitable for a federation. We know that a federation functions under a bicameral legislature. A bicameral legislature is considered to be the most appropriate one because the representatives of the different units or the different states in a federation, they can be accumulated over there. There will be proper representation of the units of the states. And whereas in case of a single house, all the members, all the representatives of the states or all the states may not be properly represented. But if there is another house, then it is easier to accommodate or to give them equal representation in both the houses. So it is always believed that the federation, for a federation, a bicameral legislature is the most suitable one. But there are arguments who say that if the constitution, if the government, the government or the state is running, is performing its functions according to the constitution, according to the rules laid down in the constitution, then there is no need of a unique of a bicameral legislature in a federation. That is, the proper representation of the people, the proper what we can say, the all the member, all the federated units, they will have their say in the legislature. If the state is running according to the constitution, in accordance with the rules laid down by the constitution, then according to some advocates of the theory of unicameralism, believe that unicameral legislature is also suitable for a federation. Another argument that has that is given in favor of a unicameral legislature is that minority interests can also be safeguarded in a unicameral legislature. Because if the state, if the intention of the state is proper, if it is carrying out its functions according to the constitution, then there is no need of a second chamber for representation of the minorities. The adoption, this can be done, the protection of the minority in the community can easily be done by the adoption of special provisions in the constitution. If there are special provisions meant for the minority communities living in a state, then there is no need of an additional house. A unicameral legislature can perform all the duties or all its functions. These are the arguments that have been given for a unicameral legislature. And scholars like Bentham or Franklin, they are in favor of a unicameral legislature. Whereas there are other scholars also who believe that a unicameral legislature is not at all suitable. There are scholars like J.S. Mill or Lasky who prefer a bicameral legislature. Now, what are their arguments? According to them, the first argument is that well-considered legislation is impossible in a unicameral legislature. That is, if there are two houses, the two houses take equal part in the legislative process or in the making of laws. So, the laws that are finally made by the legislature, they are detailed, they are discussed properly, they are being debated, and the outcome or the final law that is made or the legislation that is takes place is well considered. There is no question of any hasty decisions, or there is no possibility of any kind of what we can say loopholes in the legislation, because the two houses, they take equal part in the legislative process. The law, the legislation, the procedure of law, legislation is performed by both the houses. Both the houses go through the same procedure of passing a bill, and as a result of it, the final legislation that takes place is well considered, which is not possible in a unicameral legislature because it consists of a single house. If one house has passed the bill, that means it is passed, it will become a law. But in case of a bicameral legislature, it is sent to the other house, the other house gives its approval, and then only the legislation is complete. So from that point of view, unicameral legislature cannot make a well-considered legislation. Then the second argument given is that it is unsuitable for federation. Just now what we have discussed, that the advocates of unicameral legislature, they believe that unicameral legislatures are suitable in for a federation if the if the state is running according to the constitution. But according to the advocates of bicameral legislature, they believe that such a thing is not possible because proper representation of all the federated units is not possible in one single house. So, bicameral legislatures are the most suitable for a federation. Second, we find deficiency in excellence. What does it mean? That is, the second chamber of a legislature generally consists of the wise and the intellectuals. These people, they may not take part or may not contest elections and be the representative of the people, but they can be, in a bicameral legislature, they can be easily accommodated. Thus, advice, the suggestions of the wise and the intellectuals can easily be taken because they are nominated or they are included in the second house of the legislature. But such a thing is not possible in a single house or in a unicameral legislature, and so it is believed that there is deficiency in excellence. Those people who are wise, who are intellectuals, who have achieved something in their life, their suggestions, their advice is very important in running the state. But such a thing does not happen if the legislature consists of a single house. Next we come, interest of the minority is not protected in a unicameral legislature. It is believed that a unicameral legislature, as it consists of a single house, the number of representatives is limited. It may happen that the minority communities have not been properly represented in the single chamber or in the lower chamber. In that case, they remain unrepresented in the state, so minority interests are not secured. But if there is a second chamber and there is a provision of accommodation of people, of representatives from the minority communities, then there will be no such problem in the state. The minorities will be safeguarded, their interests will be protected if there is a second chamber in the house, in the legislature, because if for any reason they fail to represent themselves in the lower house, there is always the option of being represented in the second chamber. So these are the arguments that have been given for and against a unicameral legislature. Now, though there are so many arguments, we find that both the kinds of legislatures are there in the states, and there are some states like China which is functioning under a unicameral legislature.